Okay guys, now we are on my computer screen again. In previous video, we have designed this student report card in Jaspersoft Studio. Now in this video, we will generate this student report card through Java code. Now if you haven't watched our previous video, I strongly suggest that watch previous video first and then watch this video. Now let's open our Eclipse IDE. You can use any IDE you preferred. I am using Eclipse. Now make sure that your IDE has Maven installed in it. Now let's create a simple Java project. Now let's click on File, New. Under New, select here Maven project. Now this new Maven project window will open. Now click Next with default values. Now here in catalog, select internal and as this project is simple Java project, now we are selecting artifact ID as Maven Archetype Quick Start 1.1, version 1.1. Now click on Next. Now here you can see that I have given group ID as com.developed by Saurabh. Let's give artifact ID as Jasper Tutorial. Okay, now our package name is com.developed by Saurabh. Now click on Finish. Okay, you can see that our project is created now. So let's expand our project. Under src main java, you can see that app.java is created. It is simple hello world program. So let's run this program. Right click on it, select run as Java application. Okay, you can see that our hello world program is ran successfully and our project is now up and running. Okay, so in order to generate report, we have to include Jasper Reports library in our project. So as this is Maven project, we can include Jasper libraries in this pom.xml file. Now let's open pom.xml file. Okay, now to include Jasper Reports library in our project, open any preferred web browser and search for Jasper Jars MVN repository. Now click on first link. On this MVN repository website, you can find all the jar files related to Jasper Reports library or any other projects you are searching for. So now here you have to select one version for your Jasper Reports library. Now make sure that your Jasper Reports library version you are selecting here is similar, is exactly same as that of your Jasper Reports IDE. And here you can see that my version is 6.17.0. Okay, now close this. Now let's search for that specific version, 6.17.0. So click on this. If you have created a normal Java project without Maven, you can download these jar files from here. Here you can see that 5.4 MB jar. When you click on this, it will automatically download it. But as our project is Maven, I am selecting this dependency. So if you click on this, it will copy to clipboard. Now let's open our IDE. Okay, under this dependencies main parent tag, we have to paste our dependency. Okay, so to format it, click on Control Shift F, so it will format it. Okay, now you can see that here group ID is net.sf.jasperreports and artifact ID is Jasper Reports and the version is 6.17.0. which is same as that of our Jaspersoft Studio. So okay, now save this and wait for some time. it will reconfigure our project according to newly added dependencies. Okay friends, now we are ready to generate our first report through Java code. We will follow 5 steps we have discussed in previous videos. If you haven't watched our previous videos, I strongly suggest that please watch those videos. Then you will understand the steps we have used in this video. Okay, now let's open our Jaspersoft Studio. You can see that we have name, year, advisor and grading period fields on our main report card. And if you see in the table, our table dataset, we have subject name, total mark and marks obtained fields. So in order to pass data to our report design, we have to make bean files to hold data. You can think of these bean files as DTOs, that is data transfer objects. So let's create DTOs. For this, click on your source tab and search where you have declared your fields. Subject name, total marks and marks obtained. These fields are related to our table dataset, that is sub dataset, table dataset. And you can see that here we have declared name, year, advisor and grading period fields for our main report. So let's declare these fields in our bean file. So head over to our Eclipse IDE. We will store these bean files in a separate bean package. Okay, let's create a bean package. Right click on your main package. Under new, select package. And we will name it the package as beans. Click on finish. Under this bean package, we will create a new class. Let's say class name is student detail, as it is used as student data transfer object. Student details. And click on finish. You can see that our bean file is created. Now let's declare variables. So our first variable will be name and class is string. So we will declare the same private string name. Second field is year, third one is advisor and fourth one is grading period. So let's declare them also. Okay, now let's declare one default constructor, one parameterized constructor and getters and setters method. Okay, now our student details bean is ready. Now, in previous video while designing, I have explained that in Jasper reports, a table element is treated as a different element. Now, for table data, as we have explained in previous video, we will require a separate data set in order to pass data to our table. So, for this, we have created one parameter known as table data source in our main report. If you see, the parameter we have declared is table underscore data underscore source, and the type of this parameter is JR bean collection data source. So we will see this in action now. So for table, let's declare another bean file that will hold table data. You can see that we have 3 fields in table, that is subject name, total marks and marks obtained. Now subject name has type of string class, total marks is of type double and marks obtained is also type double. You can check the data types from here properties tab, and you can also click on source tab. You will see that here field name subject name and class is string from the jrxml file. Okay, now we will head back to our design tab and let's declare this bean for our table. So right click on beans package, under new create class let's name this bean file as student score detail and click on finish. Now similarly this bean file will store student's course detail. Now let's declare variables one by one. Private, first one is string, subject name. Now here make sure that the variables you are declaring here should match exactly with the fields you have declared in your design. So now our second field is total marks. So let's declare it. Private, data type is double and field name is TOTAL, total marks. And third field is private double marks obtained. Now similarly we will also create one default constructor, one parameterized constructor and getters and setters method. Now you can see that our bean files are ready. So for now let's close these files and let's start following the steps. Now our first step is to obtain Jasper report class object. Now in this step we will obtain Jasper report class object. Now in this step we need to obtain Jasper report class object by loading the .jasper file. .jasper file is nothing but a compiled report design created using Jasper reports library. Now start typing Jasper report and click on Control plus space. It will give you suggestion. You can see that here Jasper report class is from net.sf.jasperreports.engine package. Okay, now let's create a reference variable Jasper report. Now here we have to load our Jasper file from our directory. So for this we will use static method load object from file of JR loader class. So let's use that method of JR loader. You can see that JR loader class is coming from engine.util package. So select that one, and if you see we have load object from file. You can see that here load object method has various overloaded versions, but we will require load object from file which takes string as file name. We will select this. Now in file name for now we will pass empty string, and you can see that here it is giving us a warning that type mismatch cannot convert from object to Jasper report. So basically this method is returning an object type of data and we will have to cast it to Jasper report object. So let's follow the instruction, add cast element. Okay, now this will cast our object to Jasper report object. Now again it is giving checked exception, JR exception. Let's surround our line with try catch. Now you can see that JR loader class has this load object from file static method which requires absolute path of our .jasper file. So let's create this path. Let's say we have stored our Jasper file path in this variable Jasper file path. Now let's create Jasper file path. It will be of type string, and the value will be the file name, Jasper file name with extension. So you can see that here we have to pass Jasper file path with extension to this load object from file method in order to generate our Jasper report object. So open your Jaspersoft Studio, click on main report, expand your project, right click on JRXML, under Jasper reports click on compile report. So you can see that here .jasper file is created. Now we will use this file in order to generate our report. So right click on it, copy the .jasper file, and I am creating a new folder here in my workspace where I have created my project. We will store this .jasper file under a folder. Let's name the folder as Jasper Designs. Okay. Now let's paste the .jasper file here and copy the path of this file. You can see that we are copying the path with file name extension also. And paste the path file here. Now you can see that our Jasper file path is ready. Now this load object from file method will load our Jasper report object, will load our Jasper report object by using this student scorecard.jasper file. Okay, finally we have completed our step 1. Now step 2 is create JR data source class object. Now in this step we need to create data source object to provide the data for filling the Jasper report. In this example, a JR bean collection data source is used, which takes a list of Java objects as data source. So let's create JR data source. So search for JR bean collection data source. You can see that the JR bean collection data source is coming from Jasper reports engine.data package. So select that one and create a reference variable as data source and create new object of this class collection data, new JR bean collection data source. So you can see that we have to pass our data in the form of list object to this JR bean collection data source. So let's create Java list objects. So take list from util class and it will be of type student detail. Let's name the detail list as student detail is equal to new array list of type student details. So for this report we will be adding static data to our student detail list. In future videos we will also explain how you can populate this detail list using JDBC or other data sources. So for now let's add some static data to this detail list. Student detail list dot add, let's add a new student detail and pass this student detail list to our data source. So now this JR bean collection data source will create a data source object from this student detail list we have provided. So similarly we have to create a data source for our table element also. So let's create a data source for our table element. In the same way we have created data source for our main report, we will create data source object for our table. So let's create JR bean collection data source. So we will name this reference variable as table data source table data source new jr bean collection data source, and this time we have to pass our student scorecard detail list. So let's make student scorecard detail list. For this again we have to declare a list object of type student score detail. Let's name the reference variable as student scorecard detail list is equal to new array list of type student scorecard detail. So let's add static data to student scorecard detail also. Student scorecard detail list dot add new student scorecard detail. You can see that our JR data source for our main report data source and for our table data source are ready. So now let's add some static values to our student detail and our student scorecard detail list. So if you see student details bean class, we can provide name, year, advisor and grading period in the constructor of this class. So let's provide name, year, advisor and grading period. So let's say name will be ABCD, year will be 2023, advisor will be EFGH and grading period will be 2022 to 2023. And if you see student scorecard detail, you can see that we have to pass subject name, total marks and marks obtained. So let's add first subject. Here please notice that our subject name is in form of string data type and total marks and marks obtained are of type double. So we have to pass data accordingly. So let's pass subject name, total marks, let's say 100.0 because it is double value, and third one is marks obtained, let's say 80 marks is obtained, and the subject name will be subject 1. So let's add more subjects. This will be subject 2, this will be subject 3, this will be subject 4 and this will be subject 5. And in subject 2, let's say we have got 70 marks. In third subject, we have got 90. In fourth subject, let's say we have got 87 marks. And in last one, we have got 85. Let's save the file. Now you can see that we are adding this static details of student detail and student scorecard detail. Now our third step is create a hash map object to store parameters. Now Jasper Reports allows us to pass parameters to the report for dynamic content. In this step, we will create a hash map to store the parameters required by Fill Manager class to fill the report with data. So let's create map object. Map, let's take a map object from util class. Here key will be of type string and the value will be of type object. Let's name reference variable as parameters and we will create new hash map object. Here we are using hash map. So let's take that hash map. Our parameters object is ready. Now I will explain you what is the use of this parameters map object. You can see that in main report, we have taken name, year, advisor and grading period as our fields. So for these fields, we will be passing our data through this data source object of student detail list. And if you see the table, we have to pass separate data source object through our main report in order to populate the table elements. So in main report, we have created this table data source parameter. You can see that the class of this parameter is JRBean collection data source. And the name of this parameter is table data source. So we will pass table data by using this parameters object. So let's pass table data to our report through parameters object. So let's say parameters dot put, here string key will be the key we have defined here in Jasper design. So let's say we have taken this table data source as key, and in object we have to pass data source object of type JRBean collection data source. You can see that here class is JRBean collection data source. So we will have to pass table data source object. Let's end this statement. You can see that now this line will pass our table data to our report in the form of this parameter table data source. Now step 4 is create Jasper print object. Now Jasper print is an object that represents the field report ready for export. In this step, we will create a Jasper print object by calling the field report method of the Jasper field manager class. It takes the Jasper report object parameters and the data source as arguments. So let's create Jasper print object. Jasper print and name reference variable as Jasper print, and we are using field report method of Jasper field manager class. Jasper field manager class, and you can see that we have field report method overloaded with different. Now we will select that overloaded method of field report method that requires Jasper report parameters and JR data source as object. Now in this field report method, we will pass our Jasper report object and parameters object that will contain our table data in the form of parameters. You can see this line as we have created table data source and put it in parameters. And third one is data source, which is for our main report data source object. So let's pass data source object also. You can see that in four step we have created Jasper print object. Now here comes step 5, which is final step, and in this step we will export our Jasper print object to desired report format. Now in this step finally we can export the Jasper print object into the desired format. In this example, the report will be exported to a PDF file using Jasper export manager class. So let's export our Jasper print object to PDF file. Jasper export, you can see that Jasper export manager class is there, and we have to use static method export report to PDF file, and specifically we are using this Jasper print and string destination file name version of this export report to PDF file method. In this second parameter, we have to pass file location with file name and extension. So let's create a separate folder to store our reports Let's name it as generated reports and copy the path from here and paste it in our code. Now our file will be created in S drive under YouTube Jasper Report tutorial code and in generated reports. Now let's say our file name will be student scorecard report PDF. So let's name it as student scorecard dot PDF. You can see that we have given absolute path of where we have to generate our student scorecard PDF. So finally we will add one print statement in order to get idea that our report is generated successfully. Okay, let's save the project and let's run the project now. So right click, select run as Java application. You can see that report is generated successfully. You can see that here our student scorecard PDF is ready. Let's open it. You can see that our report is ready. Now in upcoming videos, we will be generating this student report card by using database. So stay tuned. God bless you all.